dropping bombs on your moms. Fuck call lumps. You a foul crime, I'm that nigga with your Alpine. Sold it for a 6-0. Always let tricks know and friends know we got the end up. No, I'm not a sucker sitting in the house of pain. And no, I'm not the butler. I'll cut your head, but you say you can't touch this.
Oakland, also known as the town, is a very diverse and unique city, known for its hyphy movement, sideshows, and violence. But aside the bad reputation Oakland has, it is starting to become a very touristic and sheltered city to experience. But to get more into the education side of Oakland, it has a successful school system known as OUSD that was founded in the 1800s, and is always trying to help the youth become prosperous in life. But there are always those that tend to fall through the cracks. There are 37,147 students, and out of those students, there is an estimate of 21.1% that will drop out. But what really goes on inside a youth's head when the term dropout or continuation school comes to mind?
Oakland has become like this transplant city, like from people all over who don't really live here, who aren't from the Bay. It's a lot. There's a lot of culture here, but it's different. There's a lot more people who are like hipsters, and like Oakland, you know, has this rich cultural history, and it's just starting to shift. The kind of businesses that are starting to be open, the kind of restaurants, there's a shift.
I'm not from Oakland. I've lived here like majority of my life, but I'm not from here. I think Oakland is different. It's a different type of environment. It's has its bad parts and has its good parts, which every city does, but everyone pays more attention to the bad parts of Oakland.
Oakland to me is a very diverse place just because there's different types of people, so you learn something new every day.
I think that when you look in Oakland, right, like, you know, Escalante, you know, 75% of students here are on free and reduced lunch. You have like this one side of Oakland that we see, you know, and then you have this other side of Oakland that you don't see. That's like really well off kind of Oakland, right? But you don't hear of that type of Oakland, and so the Oakland that you see every single day growing up is the poor side of Oakland. It's the Oakland where you might not have a father, and you might not have a mother, and you might occasionally hear of Oakland youth being raised by like their grandparents, primarily by like their grandmothers or by their aunties. Because a lot of the times, like, both parents are working, you know, and both parents are trying to make it, and it's hard. It's hard, especially nowadays with, you know, rent prices going up, and, you know, a lot of, like, Oakland families don't own homes, right? They come here and they rent, and they're trying to make it, and they're trying to support their children, and they're trying to be there for their children, but they just can't afford that time. Because like they have to work, and my dad was one of those people, you know, like that worked the graveyard shift, and I never got to see him, you know. And I wasn't raised by my mom. I was raised by like other people's moms, and like my coaches were my dad's. And so I think that for when we talk about education in the household and education, like I think parents want to be there, and I think they do care sincerely, but I think that time is a factor, and money is time, and they need money to pay for like priority stuff, right? They need money to pay for rent, they need money to pay for food, they need money to pay you know, to keep you healthy and safe, and they don't have enough time to invest into education like they would love.
Shady mob, nigga, get it straight. Shout out to them niggas in these streets moving heavyweight. Up in LV with my niggas for a getaway. Stepped in the party, I don't care what they gotta say. Got a few shots for them niggas trying to get at me. And I don't give a fuck if you niggas ain't feeling. rimming. Non-stop cheaper, mean a nigga smoking hella weed. Out of town with my bitch, sipping on some Hennessy. How to get a weapon for my motherfucking enemy.
I think that when students have structure and they have expectations, they rise to the occasion every time. If you know that your parent expects nothing but A's and B's from you, or they expect you to be a good stylist student, you're gonna work to perform in that way. If you feel like your parents don't expect anything from you, you're not gonna do anything, because that's the expectation. So I think that children are successful when they have structure and when they have boundaries. And so I think parents really play a big role in that.
My generation, we used to all hang out, go to the skate room, do little sideshow stuff. It was much more safer. Now it's like kids have no outlook on anything. They could care less. They always want to try to fight, guns, drugs. When I was coming up, you hardly even seen kids my age on drugs. Now you do, but back then it was a lot safer and a lot funner.
I've seen a lot of people engage in violence, engage in drugs at a very young age, engage in alcohol at a very young age. And it's because, like, you know, I think that the older people don't feel like their actions are responsible, right? But when younger people see what it is that they're doing, like, you know, smoking or drinking or doing X, Y, and Z, then youth want to do that too, because they want to replicate those things, right? But then it develops into a pattern, and it develops into a cycle. And, you know, I have a lot of friends that end up dropping out in the 6th grade, you know, in the 7th grade, in the 8th grade. And a lot of, like, my friends that are, like, gangsters now, you know, were really nerds in elementary school, in middle school, and halfway, like, through high school. And in high school, you know, they got with the wrong cliques, right? Because they wanted to be cool, and they gave up their genius in order to be cool.
When you're young, you never really realize economic struggle. Like, you don't really know, because it's not like that to you unless your parents explain it to you, and then even then you have to understand it. So it did, but I didn't notice it, so it just seemed normal. Plus everybody else was pretty much in the same position in the general area, so we were all going through the same things. It was normal. It was a normal thing.
I think specifically my parents are the ones that affect the way I think about school, just because they didn't finish high school, so I believe that's like a really big impact and influence.
Like me personally, like Oakland wants me, or makes me want to do better in school, so that way I myself could get out of Oakland, because I wouldn't say it's a bad place to be, but it's definitely not the best. And that goes for a lot of students that grow up in bad communities or bad neighborhoods. They tend to use it as a motivation rather than let it affect them negatively.
Sometimes it's not always about the grades. Sometimes it's not always about what SAT scores you get, what colleges you got denied to or accepted to. You know, it doesn't matter on that. Sometimes it really matters on whether or not someone knows what they're doing, whether or not someone feels like what they're doing actually has any meaning to it. Because we have an expectation that once we graduate out of high school, if we graduate even, that we should just go to college, get a bachelor's degree, maybe get a job. But other than that, we're just basically given a kick to the boot and just say, hey, go out in the real world, you gotta figure it out yourself. And I honestly don't think that it should be that way. I do think that there should be some learning experiences on a personal level, but I considered dropping out because I didn't know what to do. And if it weren't for people to help me to figure out what I was supposed to do, I honestly would have screwed up big time one little thing that I didn't know about. And my whole 4 years that I worked my ass off for would have been over. So I honestly think there should be safety nets to prevent that, and that people should feel motivated, compelled, and honestly inspired by what they do here. But that's not the case.
We'll be right back.
I'm not the butler. I'll cut ya, headbutt ya. You say you can't touch this, said I wouldn't touch ya. In fact, motherfucker, here to let you know.